Hey there folks, Aldershot here, and today we are back with some more Long Dark. And as promised in our last episode, I took some time off camera. I burned away a few calories. I made our way from the far end of the coastal highway back to the convenience store. And we burned off 8 days since our last episode, burning away all our excess cargo and all our excess goods that we don't need. And I'll show you what we have that we're taking with us. So for our first aid, this is what we got. This is the clothing that we're going to take with us. All in good condition now because I took some time to repair with the leftover materials. This is all of the food that we're going to take with us. I ate all the meat because they weighed the most. I didn't want to lug those around because of that reason, right? We're going to take a little over 2 kilograms of water with us with 4 cans of soda, right? And these are the tools that we're going to take with us. We're going to keep as much fire utensils as possible, although we're going to drop this fire striker because it's a pretty low condition. And we're trying to conserve on weights as much as possible for obvious reasons. You know, I'm expecting to find loots along the way as we make our way to Timberwolf Mountain. And I did do some research off camera on how to get there so I don't derp around too much. We will have to go through Pleasant Valley. So we have to go northeast of the coastal highway to find the entrance way to Pleasant Valley. And we'll see where we go from there. I'll show you some of the goodies that we're going to leave behind. So this is all the, you know, excess food and consumables that we're going to leave behind. I know it's a lot of good stuff, but what can we do, right? This is our crafting materials that we'll be leaving behind. It pains me so much to have to leave behind the cured wolf pelts and the cured deer hide, but unfortunately, if we want to move in at a reasonable rate, we just have to make some sacrifices. These are our equipments that we're going to leave behind. We got a lot of flares, like a lot of flares, right? And again, it pains me to have to leave even one flare behind, but c'est la vie. We have to conserve on weights, so that is what we have to do. And I believe I got some first aid kit stuff left behind here as well. We got some stuff curing here that we'll probably not pick up because, again, we have to conserve on weights. And these are all the excess clothing that I'm not going to miss at all. You know, it's just cloth and all that stuff. So with that said, and with everything accounted for, we shall start making our trek to Timberwolf Mountain. Wish us luck. Wish me luck, guys. Because I can see this being quite treacherous, to say the least, right? There's going to be wolves out here. Actually, I'm going to pick up one flare from our cargo because I have the feeling that we're going to need to use it because there's a fair amount of wolves waiting for us outside. So that way, you know, we'll replace that flare by using an extra one, right? We are still traveling a bit over encumbered, right? But I'm just going to have to deal with that. All right, we got 11 hours of daylight left today. It's a little snowy, but I think we should be fine. No wolves yet. Oh, there he is. Hello. I knew you were here somewhere. Get out, get out. I don't want none of your business there. All right. He's probably going to come after us again, but we'll deal with him when that time comes. Our flare should be going for a little while, so should offer us some protection at the very least. So we gotta go up this path. We gotta go northwest. I know I said northeast earlier. I meant to say northwest. Alright, we'll just keep this little buddy flare with us for a little while. And hopefully it'll offer us enough protection from wolves, right? And a little update, guys. I am planning on getting an upgrade to my computer rig tomorrow. Yeah, going to get a new graphics card, a GTX 970. And that means I'll be able to record future episodes of The Long Dark, as well as just videos in general, in hopefully 60 frames a second, in the highest quality possible, all for, you know, your viewing pleasure, and for my recording pleasure, right? So I'm pretty excited about that. And also, if you guys haven't checked it out yet, since our last episode, Hinterland Studios released a brand new trailer to their upcoming story mode that they're planning on implementing. And it looks pretty damn fancy, guys. I mean, it's super fancy, I would even say. Yeah, they got like 3D character models as a replacement from their planned 2D character illustrations for their cutscenes. And it looks really good. You know, they've done a good job in their rendering and their artistic take and all that kind of stuff. The voice acting seems really nice. They got some great voice actors working for them. I'm really excited, guys. Really, really excited. Once story mode comes out, you can be sure that I will be covering it in full. So I'm pretty excited about that. I'm pretty excited about my computer upgrade. I'm generally just pretty excited. I'm pretty excited about leaving Coastal Highway. Finally, right? So this is just generally a pretty exciting day, I think. Yeah, I think it's pretty safe to say that. Now, I think we gotta go this way. So I guess we'll go this way. Why not? Alright, so we're... no wolves. So that's a good sign. One wolf, but we scared him off. So that's good. There's a bear up ahead. And he's right on the path to the exit of Coastal Highway. So that's kind of dangerous. And by the way, while checking through my locker, I found bullets. So yeah, we're fully locked and loaded and good to go, really. Anyways, I dropped my flare, which I'm going to pick up because just in case of, you know, further wolf attacks. We're looking pretty good. A little peckish, so we'll grab a small bite to eat. Probably this, because it's kind of low condition anyways, 53. And there we go. That should be good enough for now. Where did our bear friend go? Okay, so he's just up ahead. I'm going to try and avoid him by going up this hill here. And hopefully he won't attack us, because that would definitely mean certain death. And I would rather not die, you know. We came all this way, day 38. And it would be pretty silly to get killed by a bear attack again. I've been killed by bears more than once. For our longtime viewers, they would know that. It's super sad when it happens. At least it makes me super sad anyways. Anyways, let's see. Yeah, we're gonna go up this way. He's going the same way that we're going. I guess it's better than him coming towards us, so I guess I should look on the bright side. Anyways, we should go up this path anyway, so this works out. Okay, that's good. And there goes the flare. We can throw that now. Alright. We're going to take it slow and easy as not to tire ourselves out. Because, yeah, it's going to be a long trek. We're going to be playing nomadically for a good few episodes, I think. Because we have to find our way to the Pleasant Valley entranceway. And then we have to find our way out of Pleasant Valley into Timberwolf Mountain. And from my understanding, Timberwolf Mountain is mostly outdoors, so I gotta be prepared for that. It's going to be very dangerous, I would imagine. Very dangerous indeed. But I'm pretty sure I'm going the right way. I checked the map. Yes, I know, kind of cheating. I generally don't like doing that, but for the sake of this let's play, I did actually check the map. And I think some of you guys actually mentioned the direction in which I'm supposed to go, which does align with the map that I checked, so works out. Anyways, we should be hitting the watchtower of Coastal Highway pretty soon, which is a good sign. That means we are going the right way. I do recognize this path, and I do believe this is the way to the watchtower, so therefore also the way to Pleasant Valley, which also means it's the way to Timberwolf Mountain. All that kind of good stuff. It's a bit snowy today, just a tad, but the weather is fine though. Minus 20, but because of our nice wolfskin coats, and our boots, and our pants, yeah, we're doing pretty good as far as body temperature is concerned. So, that's good. It's not a bad thing. Yeah, right now I'm actually playing on medium graphical settings in order to avoid screen jittering and all that kind of nonsense, right? But once I get my new graphics card, we're going to hit back up on that ultra settings and hopefully 60 frames per second recording as well. That would be a good thing. That would definitely not be a bad thing, you know? All right, enough running. I spent like 2.5 hours preparing for this video. It was a lot of time burning, a lot of preparation, a lot of item management. So hopefully you guys will enjoy this episode. No, we're not going to stop in there. I don't think we need to. We still got 9 hours of daylight left, which is plenty of time. We're not tired because we've been kind of micromanaging our stamina. Effectively, so far anyways. Starting to get a little hungry, so we'll grab another bite to eat. Let's see, let's go by condition. This will give us 600, and it's the lowest condition, so we'll use that. We do need to find a new can opener, though. Our current one is not the greatest condition. I'll show you guys that now. 40%, not the greatest. Our rifle's not the greatest condition either. So we'll have to figure something out about that. We'll worry about it when we need to. Maybe we'll search around Pleasant Valley. We'll definitely search around Pleasant Valley. We'll definitely make camp at the homestead, at least for a night or two anyways, to recoup some of our supplies, and if we get hurt or anything like that, to obviously heal up. But hopefully that won't be the case, for obvious reasons. But anyway, so far so good. We're passing the watchtower, which does mean that we are going the right way. So that is not a bad thing. I just want to run just a tad. Okay, enough. Because I don't want to, you know, wind myself. I don't want to get tired and have to find shelter and all that jazz. But I believe just up ahead, I don't think we're far from the entrance to Pleasant Valley, actually. I think we're pretty close, if I recall correctly, which I might not be, because my memory is not the greatest, as you guys know, but, you know, I'm pretty sure this is the right way. Like, I'm 90% sure this is the right way. 80% sure that this is the right way. 76.5% sure this is the right way. I'm trying to give myself as much room for error as possible here, guys. I know myself as well as you guys do, okay? I know how derpy I can be, so, you know. Alright, I'm like, now I'm 90% sure this is the right way. This is definitely the right way. Okay, good. Good. I'm getting a little bit thirsty. I want to wait for our hunger to go down a little bit. That way we'll drink a soda. Actually, you know what, we're getting fairly thirsty. We'll just drink some water. We'll save the soda, I guess. Let's see. Water. Here we go. Very good. That should help with our weight a little bit as well. Although I would like to maintain my water level above 1 liter, you know. Anyways, leave Coastal Highway. Oh boy, guys, we survived at least that portion of the trek. Now for this portion, we're gonna grab this because we're gonna need the lantern. We're not gonna need the cloth. Here we go. It is full. I did fill it before we leave, or left, I should say. Past tense. Nothing in there. No, I don't want to extinguish. Right, I can't open it. Okay, fair enough. Still kind of want to take it slow. Take it nice and easy. Use up our daylight as much as possible. Although we're inside now, I guess that's not as important. But I don't know. I still want to be somewhat conservative with our resources. I'm not sure. Okay, this is the part I'm kind of confused about. I think we have to keep going north, so we'll keep going north. Although I do kind of want to explore the mines a little bit. To maybe find a rifle, because rifles do spawn in mines. I have found rifles here before. Maybe not specifically this mine, but a mine, you know. Some kind of mine. Alright, well, anyways. Weird, I couldn't check that. Okay, whatever. Oh, we'll definitely take the candy bar. Don't need the news roll. We'll leave that. We'll definitely take the energy bar. Oh my, that's really good. Alright, so far so good. Alright, I think we came this way. Came from that way, so maybe this way is the way out. See, this is the part that I didn't look up via the interwebs. So I'm kind of on my own here. I can only hope that I'm going the right way. Stats still looking pretty good. We're away from dangers of critters in the mines, which is not a bad thing. Ooh, lockers. Let's check what's in here. Don't want that. Gotta be picky right now. We're traveling nomadically, so what we pick up will absolutely have a huge effect in our survival. We'll take that, sure. And we'll take the matches. We gotta be careful, though. We get... Oh, rifle cleaning kit. I don't think I have one of those yet. Nope, don't want that. If we're not careful, we can become over-encumbered, which is kind of slowly happening. I might be getting a little too greedy with the loot here. Anyways, let's keep going. This definitely looks like a dead end. Sorry about the yawning, guys. I stayed up really late. Like, it's 8 in the morning right now, and I haven't slept yet. Yeah, I know. But I don't have work till, like, late in the afternoon. So I don't... I'm kind of okay, you know? And I'm planning on releasing a video before or after this. I'm not sure yet. On Leap of Fate. So if it's before this episode I released, then hopefully you guys will check that out as well. It's an interesting little roguelike, you know, or roguelite. And if I release it after this episode, hopefully you guys will look forward to it. More videos, the better, right? Anyways, starting to get tired because I'm abusing the run button. So let's take it easy. We'll take a nap before we exit the mine as well. Assuming we can find the exit. But I'm starting to see some daylight, so... Yep, okay, I think this is the right way. I think this is it right here, guys. Alright, good stuff. And we definitely haven't been here yet. We're gonna leave this lantern fuel, we're gonna leave the leather. And we are going to take a little nap here. Roll out the bedroll. Sleep. Let's see, we got 8 hours of daylight left. Let's sleep for 3 and see what happens. Alright, let's pick this baby back up. Oh, looking pretty good, actually. Oh, fairly rested, actually. Oh, not bad. Not bad at all. And we got 5 hours of daylight left. So, let's put away our lantern and see if we exited the right, well, exit. I'm pretty sure we have. Pleasant Valley, alright, mission success, guys. We did it. We did it. So, we're in Pleasant Valley now, guys. So, I'm going to end the episode here. And in our next episode, we will work our way out of Pleasant Valley. Actually, we'll find our way to the coastal. We're not in Coastal Highway anymore. We'll find our way to the farmer's homestead. And we'll make camp for the night there. We won't stay there for very long, though. We're just going to go there to counter supplies, to maybe boil up some more water, and to loot the place, see what kind of goodies we can find in there. Maybe a new rifle. That would be kind of cool, right? But for the time being, we will end the episode here. And hopefully you folks enjoyed this, you know. If you did, you know, show me some love, as usual. Like, share, fave, and comment. And if you haven't already, subscribe, and I'll bring you lots more Long Dark and other great video games videos for you guys, for your entertainment and maybe education, mostly entertainment though. Anyways, folks, thank you so much for watching, as usual. I'm gonna be out. We will see you in the next episode.